All right, Gorilla, what do you think about the situation now with the New Age Outlaws? I mean, to me
personally...
Well,
they kind of went overboard, didn't
they? That's what I was going to say. They've gone a little too far.
Here I was speaking about the voice of reason earlier. How do you explain the fact that they went overboard?
Well, you know, they literally took out the trash.
Well, as a matter of fact, they did take out the trash, but the fact of the matter is, here is two of the youngest, brightest superstars in the World Wrestling Federation, the tag team champions, and I think they took care of business in helping themselves make a name.
No, they went beyond taking care of business, Tom.
I don't understand that at all. I think they went just...
You know, they tried to terminate the career of these two gentlemen, and, you know, they've been reprimanded for that, and there's still things to come from that, I'm sure. If they think that that's what's going to make them successful here in the WWF, they're mistaken.
Well, obviously, as you said earlier, who has the gold?
Well, they do.
That's right. Thank you.
Temporarily.
Well, in that case, Mr. Pritchard, why are they still trying to make a name for themselves? They are the tag team champions.
If you rest on your laurels, you know you're just going to get trampled. These guys want to keep on going and going and going, as does D-Generation X.
All right, Colin Elbow into the corner, and Billy Gunn does not make a clean break on the referee's request.
Usually when you do something like that, you take actions like that, you do it because you're not confident.
Absolutely.
Oh, these guys, look at the confidence of B.A. Billy Gunn, and look at how developed this guy is. He has worked on his body, he has worked on his ring skills, as has the Road Dog. I think they have all the confidence in the world.
Well, that's what makes the world go around, difference of opinion.
Roll up, but Billy Gunn holds onto the rope, comes back with a clothesline, no one was home, and beautiful hip toss by Flash Funk.
I've got to say, Flash Funk has a lot of confidence, too.
And the Road Dog gets clobbered by Flash Funk.
You know, speaking of confidence, Mr. President and Mr. Rougeau, at No Way Out of Texas this Sunday, Shawn Michaels, Triple H, and the Road Dog, B.A. Billy Gunn, how are these massive egos going to coexist on one side against people like Stone Cold, Owen Hart, Cactus Jack, and Chainsaw Charlie?
Well, why don't you tell us? You're the one that's so keen on the New Age Outlaws, Shawn Michaels, and Triple H.
Well, in my opinion, I think they're going to coexist very well. Here are four men with the same ideas in mind, same opinions, same way of life. I mean, I think they're going to get along great.
Well, and really, I will do anything and everything to get it done.
What's possible is done. What's impossible will be done. I think they will do anything and
well,
everything.
Let's not forget that they're in there with some loose cannons.
Yeah?
So anything could happen.
Name me one.
It probably will.
I hope so.
And it's going to happen this Sunday live on pay-per-view.
Looks like Brandy is now letting a lot of things happen to him with B.A. Billy Gunn and the Road Dogs stomping him in their corner. This is the Mark of True Champions, keeping them on their side of the ring.
They do some technical things very well. They do some unorthodox things extremely well.
I think that's what, again, makes the world go around here in the WWF, doing the unorthodox, making it work for you.
And right now, a referee has his back turned to the corner, and the Road Dog taking advantage of Brandy trying to fight back, but in enemy territory right now.
Well, Brandy has been known for having the hardest hands in the WWF, and when you have a feud against a guy like Mark Merrill, that'll come in handy.